Nityanandam Swamiji, the Paramashiva is the sound in us. When there is no sound created by us, and Dakshinamurti is the no visualization state of us. And so, how Mahadevi can be interpreted, and on what we have to concentrate to achieve the oneness?
Vijayan, all the ideas you presume here are wrong and false. So your whole question and the ideas, concepts on which you are building the whole question is wrong. Paramashiva is sound and silence. Dakshinamurti is visualization and absence and no visualization. And all your visualization disappearing into the great light. Visual silence does not mean absence of visuals. All visuals dissolved into the greatest visual, supernal effulgence of me. So all your binary logic ideas have no base. And every word you have uttered here is delusion. Next.
The next question, question number 4, from Constance Chapin from Guadeloupe. Nityanandam Swamiji, what is my mission at Kailasa?
None of you have any work or mission in Kailasa. I have decided Kailasa is going to be run directly by gods and goddesses. All human beings can come only for darshan and program to Kailasa. No human beings are allowed to stay in Sri Kailasa. The gods and goddesses are going to run the Kailasa directly, including administration. Annapurani is here physically to run the Annalaya of Kailasa. If she decides, she is interested in manifesting through you. And if you decide to do tyaga and surrender your being at her feet, and if she decides to manifest through you, then as long as she decides to manifest through you, you decide to allow her to manifest through you, you will have visa in Kailasa. You can be volunteering in Annalaya department. Either one of you decide not to allow the other to manifest. If you decide, you don't want to allow Annapurani to manifest through you, or the Annapurani decides she doesn't want to manifest through you, you go back to Bhuloka. You go back to planet Earth. So no human beings in Kailasa. It's very clear. Any human being who is ready to do tyaga of his being, sarva parityaga, and ready to manifest the gods and goddesses of Kailasa are welcome to apply. Once you apply, those gods and goddesses will directly interview you, and then they decide whether you will have a mission in Kailasa or not. All permanent residency in Kailasa is only for gods and goddesses. The bodies chosen by the gods and goddesses for them to manifest. All human beings are welcome to come and have darshan, initiation, attend programs, receive boons and go back. Human beings will get only visa. Only gods and the bodies through which gods have decided to manifest are going to get permanent residency or mission. So be very clear, Venkateshwara and Mahalakshmi is directly going to run the treasury and finance ministry. Kalabhairava is directly going to run the security. Each department, those gods and goddesses from Kailasa are directly going to run and administer. The home ministry will be directly run by Parashakti. Annalaya directly by Annapurani. Each department will be run directly by my own manifestations, gods and goddesses of Kailasa. Anybody who is ready to do sarva parityaga, including their being, for those gods to manifest in you, you are welcome to apply. Then they decide whether you receive visa or permanent residency or citizenship.